Going out for around about 45 minutes, something like that. Just a couple of things prior to departure. Firstly, life jackets. Plenty of life jackets on board for haul and sundry. The large white boxes up in front of the wheelhouse. Chock-a-block full of life jackets, as is the aft hold. No cause for alarm. No intention whatsoever of sinking today. Relax and enjoy yourself.
Come on! Thank you.
Steel track railway in Australia through to Port Elliot. Port Elliot was loaded on a sailing vessel for shipment around through Adelaide. You can see the smaller steamer there. We were visited by the larger Duke of Edinburgh as well that comes down. It takes people along the railway line, along the coastline through to Victor Harbour on a trip and return to Goolwa, of course, on a trip known as the Cockle Run. But there's only two places in the world where you can actually catch a steam locomotive down to the water's edge and catch a steam paddle wheeler away from it. One, of course, is right here at Goolwa. The other is on Lake Lucerne in Switzerland. channel this time. You notice out here there's quite a number of poles poking up out of the water with different colour and different shape top marks on them. These are navigation markers. They let us know exactly where the deep water channels are. Shortly. This of course links High Marsh Island on our starboard right hand side with the mainland and the River Port of Goolwa. You'll notice as we go under the bridge, directly under the bridge up on the lawns, the grey hull and the white steering wheel of an old barge. That's the Dart. She was actually the last vessel to be built here in Goolwa in the heyday of the boat building. 1914 was her birthday. She spent most of her working days being towed around the rivers of Australia by the Oscar W. Boat festival. As you can see, there's some absolutely delightful wooden craft. Many man hours have been spent on these craft to get them up to the state you see them in today. Just like Oscar W, actually, all of the work to get it up to this standard, folks, has been done by volunteers. She's been totally rebuilt, and she's a lovely old vessel, very, very strong. We're very proud of her to have her down in these waters. Folks, we'll be rounding up very, very shortly and making our way back towards the wharf. Folks, when we go back into our wharf, we'll be going back in where we normally tie up, just opposite the riverboat centre up there, not where we actually departed from. Finish your steam, thanks Chief. Well folks, as you can see, we're now safely back alongside the wharf. The gangway will be coming aboard very, very shortly, and you can continue doing what you're doing for the rest of the day. Enjoy the Wooden Boat Festival, have a good look around, and I hope you enjoyed your trip out on Oscar W.
Yeah, so.
What's the problem, young lady?
Thank you.
seen London just leaving. Well-known buddies around here, John London, they're involved in the sale. So he's away, sure they with a 1358 horsepower boat built in 1932. Still, but Perkins Brunton as the bigger boat move out.
And that's a magnificent boat, the Emu, now owned by Greg and Janine Westman. And the Mayflowers going out, and we thank them for coming so far. Coming all the way down from Manham in the recently relaunched Mayflower. One of the oldest, well, it is the oldest paddle steamer or paddle boat in the on the river. And it's great to see them come down from Manham and join us.
Yeah.
wooden boat festivals, and a fantastic boat, one of the outstanding conversions or refurbishments on a boat you'd see. That's D2 Lotus. Wild Goose is just getting the direction all right. Inboard. That's Wild Goose. Now here's the Oscar W. They're blowing down a bit of steam just before they get here. We'll let you know. Thanks, fellas. So these guys are giving us the big cheerio, and what they're doing in effect is thanking you for being so good to come down to this festival and watch them perform. They're chipping through, and those people are having a very, very lucky to have a ride on these magnificent craft. The Oscar W. Give them a wave and say that you really enjoyed the festival. Thanks for the contribution from the Oscar W. Good luck to the Marion, all the way down from Manham, and lucky people having a ride on her. She's 120 years old this year, I think, and beautiful. As you can see, the extra level of her accommodation's been put there. There's a lot of cruising out of Manham, both daily, weekends and weekly, and a magnificent way to spend your time on the river. He's been coming down here with Goldie. He used to bring it down from Port Augusta in the earlier days, and it's great to have Mike down there. He's been attending for about 20 years. That's a little but great to see you down here, Goldie. Thanks for coming. Commissioned only last November, and doing a great job. And the young crew on that have brought it across. It's their first experience for a lot of them across the lake. They have to be very careful, and we'll see that they get a good escort back across the lake probably Monday if the wind doesn't come up in the meantime. Make it a lot easier to use, and that's the paddle steamer William Randall. Thanks for joining us. Flight Spirit, H16 there, the big cruiser, Rooney Weeks. It's a Carville Harbour. D1, of course, is Graham Hardy, Ione 2. Winsome goes through, the old Popeye. Great to see her still going on the water. She's been around for many, many years. H12 is Kettwig, from Taylor and Ben, Jeff Nichols. The 1983 Hartley design, Big Hartley.